Sleep has to be the single most important thing we can do for our health, allowing our body to rest and recover, giving it the time it needs to repair. But due to the current uncertain times we are experiencing, getting those 8 hours of shut eye seems to be quite difficult. We chat to sleep expert Dr. Dale Ray on the benefits of a good night's rest and why it's so important for your health. Now, Nicole Austin, I mean, as our sleep correspondent, or rather, I should say, the lack of sleep correspondent, health correspondent, as a mommy.
Sleep, what is that? What was this foreign concept? How do you spell that, Pali?
No, listen, we were speaking about this before, and I mean, I welcome you too, Dr. Dale Ray, to the loft, as we do divulge in all things sleep.
Hi, Palesa, and thanks for having me. It's been a tough year. So I think a couple of things have changed for people. Obviously, there's this big shift in routine. So people were in a routine of going to work every day, doing all the things that you need to do, ticking them off, frightfully busy, and then suddenly you had to work from home or change a whole lot of things. And so with routine going out the window, it makes sleep really difficult because it's a routine-oriented behavior. The other thing, of course, that has changed is this huge stress, anxiety, worry, uncertainty related to the pandemic. And anybody who's experienced a little bit of anxiety, read into that, every one of us will know exactly that that is possibly one of the number one destroyers of sleep.
Well, that's exactly it. Sleep and anxiety, they are major causes for sleep disorders. I personally know what it feels like to be so stressed that you can't sleep. Yeah. Doctor, how does dealing with all the stress and anxiety that a lot of us are dealing with at the moment during this pandemic affect sleep?
Yeah, unfortunately, stress and anxiety are one of the primary causes very often of something that we all are familiar with, which is insomnia. It doesn't mean to say necessarily that you've got chronic insomnia, although that's a different story, but a lot of us through this pandemic and through the stress and the anxiety and uncertainty that's going on have experienced a good deal of short-term or more acute type insomnia. And essentially what happens is at nighttime we let our guards down, or we're supposed to let our guard down, so that we can repair and recover physically, mentally, and emotionally. But unfortunately, if there's a lot of stress and anxiety or worry that's sort of in the back of our minds during the daytime, if we don't give it airtime during the daytime, it's going to infiltrate into your sleep, because that's the time of day when we do a lot of processing and understanding of all the things that we are feeling.
Wow, I mean, that just blew my mind. You need to give all those stresses and anxiety opportunity during the day, deal through it. Yeah. So then another important question that a lot of people just need to understand. Number one, how important is sleep? And number two, what is considered a good night's rest?
Such seemingly simple questions and such complex answers. So the thing is, without sleep, we don't survive. It's that simple. If you were to stay awake without ever sleeping, you would literally die. So it's that critical. And it's no sense of chance that there isn't a single creature alive on this planet that doesn't need a downtime and a period of sleep. So sleep's critical for survival. It's got a number of other factors that are important, which enables us to literally be on our mental, physical, and emotional A game. But what is good night? What does it look like? What is good sleep? It's different for different people, and it's not just about duration. And that's the thing that really bothers me. People speak so much about how much sleep am I getting. Actually, the question you should be asking is, how good is the quality of my sleep? Yeah. And how do you test that? You look at, how do I feel during the daytime? Do I feel alert? Can I multitask? Can I control my emotions? Can I remember things? And if those things are starting to fall apart, then you can look backwards and decide, well, what role is sleep playing here? Am I getting good, consolidated, uninterrupted sleep of sufficient duration for me to be on my A game?
Yeah, exactly. Well, you mentioned the role of sleep. What role does it have in helping and maintaining a healthy immune system?
Sleep's critical for immunity. During the daytime, when we're exposed to lots of germs and pathogens and the like, part of our immune system that is active is that which defends us against anything which we might inhale, ingest, or absorb. This is obviously all too familiar now with us, with our masks and the things that we do to try to prevent the distribution of germs. But at nighttime, our immune system changes role, and that another part of the system, immunity, is very, very, very busy and very active at nighttime. And this is the part of your immune system which makes the antibodies, for example, that you might need to defend against the germs or the pathogens to which you were exposed during the daytime. Your immune system also spends a lot of time at night repairing any cells that have become damaged or mutated. And this obviously is super important from an anti-cancer role.
So then, doctor, finally, what tips then do you have to help people get that good night's rest?
Probably the most straightforward thing to do is to think about, can I prioritize sleep? We prioritize work, and some of us will also prioritize family time, self time, exercise time, time to have meals that are healthy. But how many people actually prioritize sleep? For many people, sleep time is just a time sink. Well, I've only got 24 hours in the day. I needed to get a lot done, and I'll sleep with whatever time is kind of left over. That's not ideal. So really what we ask people to do is to think about, how can I prioritize sleep and protect that time viciously? And then make sure that the things that you're doing in the daytime aren't going to impair your sleep. So if you're struggling to fall asleep, but you're having a nap in the late afternoon, you need to ask yourself, is this helping my nighttime sleep? If you're using a lot of stimulants, a lot of nicotine, anything like that as an upper during the daytime, those things can impact your sleep. You need to have a beautiful place to sleep. Your bedroom needs to be one of your favorite places in the world, so that you get excited at the end of the day to hop into bed and to start that sleeping process. And then as much as possible, to have a lot of structure and routine around sleep is important, because sleep is a habit and your body loves rhythm and routine. And if you do similar things relating to your sleep on a daily basis, it makes it much easier for your body to anticipate sleep and anticipate what it is that you wish for it to do.
Well, that's a lot to think about, Doctor. I mean, you too, Nicole. What's really helped me, as well as I just reflect on everything that you've spoken about, is that routine. For me, it's critical.
Absolutely. And I think I started the show by joking about sleep, but I genuinely do believe in the power of sleep. And even last year, I started instituting it as a priority in our home, because we need to make sure that we're teaching our kids how to sleep from when they're young. We're encouraging sleep as a healthy part of a lifestyle, not just eating well and taking your supplements and exercising, but also sleeping correctly.
Well, thank you so much, Doctor, for stopping by Afternoon Express. Goodbye.
Thanks. Cheers.
Now, from sleep to something that you probably shouldn't be sleeping on, and that is all things survival and your protection. I mean, Nicole, having these conversations every single week just reminds me how lucky we are as people to be able to come around each other, help each other out of very traumatic situations, and be able to, you know, give back a little.
Absolutely. We can give to each other right by now by sharing our stories. We can share the challenging tribulations that we've been through to be able to lift up and encourage one another, and also to win.
Absolutely, Nicole. And on that note, do you have a survival story? Well, then we want to hear from you. Share your survival story with us, from surviving a failed parachute to escaping a lion attack. We want to hear your story. Imuenza is giving away 5,000 Rand a week for 5 weeks. And all you have to do is to reply to the Imuenza competition post on the Afternoon Express Facebook page or Twitter page and tell us your survival story and what protected you using the hashtag Imuenza. Competition closes on the 10th of March 2021 at midnight, and terms and conditions can be found on afternoonexpress.co.za. Help support your immune system for your next big adventure with Imuenza.